Good morning to everybody. Dear students, I welcome you all to BCA second sum mathematics subjects. I am your mathematics lecturer. We'll start our BCA mathematics syllabus with the chapter number name called complex numbers. Complex numbers are also a type of numbers. It is denoted by letter Z, alphabetical letter Z, and general form of the complex number are denoted by Z is equals to X plus IY. Z is equals to X plus IY. Here Z is complex number and this is X is called real part and Y is called imaginary part, and this I is called iota, and its value is I is equals to minus I square is equals to minus 1. I square is equals to minus 1. If it's single I, if you take I square is equals to I is in minus 1, square root of minus 1. I square is minus 1, you should remember that value. Okay, what are the subtopics in this complex numbers we come across? That is ordered pair of complex number, ordered pair of complex numbers. Here ordered pair means writing the real part and imaginary part in a bracket. That is in bracket X comma Y. This real part, this is real part and this is imaginary part. If you take Z is equals to 1 plus I, here X is X, this is Y, and writing them in bracket that is 1 comma 1. This is ordered pair. You should write them along with sign. That is, take another example, Z minus 1 minus 1 minus I. Here in this second example, X is equals to minus 1 and Y is equals to minus 1. Ordered pair is minus 1 comma minus 1. This is an ordered pair. In these ordered pair are represented on XY plane. In next class we will see that. Okay. As I told earlier, real and imaginary part, real complex numbers Z is equals to X plus IY. Here X is called real part and Y is called imaginary part. Next, models of a complex number. We come across this in next class. Just modulus is complex number is denoted by mod Z and its value is square root of X square plus Y square. Modulus of a complex number is denoted by mod Z and its value is square root of X square plus Y square. Amplitude is theta, value, angle theta, its value is tan inverse of Y by X. Amplitude means it's a value theta, its value is tan inverse of Y by X. It depends on four quadrants where XY values lies. Here it is, if you take X coordinate, this is X coordinate, and all positive, this is Y coordinate, this is negative, X dash, this is negative, Y dash. Here X comma X, plus comma plus, X is plus and Y is also plus, plus plus. Here X is minus and Y is plus. Okay. Here both are negative and here X is positive and Y is negative. Likewise, the coordinates are the points x and y represented on the xy plane. This is real line where x values are positive. This is real line or negative side. This is 0. Real line positive. This is real line negative. This is imaginary positive, imaginary negative. Okay. Next, polar form. Polar form of a complex number. Z is equals to r into cos theta plus I sin theta. Here, r is a modulus of the complex number, and theta is amplitude. When complex number is given in Cartesian coordinate, we will express the Cartesian coordinate complex number into polar form by using the relation x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sin theta. Next, De Morgan's theorem. We have a one theorem for representing the solving the power of a complex number by using the theorem, namely cos theta plus I sin theta whole to the power of n. This power is multiplied to theta, that is cos n theta plus I sin n theta. By using this De Morgan's theorem, we calculate the square root and cube root of a complex number and represent them in xy plane. That plane is called Argando plane. In next class, we will do detailed explanation of the ordered pair, real and imaginary part, modulus and amplitude, and we will solve some problems regarding modulus and amplitude, polar form, and finding the square root and cube root of a complex number. Okay, thank you all. Dear students, we will take a topic complex number one by one. Ordered pair. Ordered pair of complex number. Ordered pair of a complex number. Let us take one example. Z is equals to x plus iy. Here, x is called real part and y is called imaginary part. And here x is equals to 1 and y is equals to 1. Representing these values of x and y in xy plane, writing them in square in bracket, it is called an ordered pair. That is 1 comma 1. This is x and this is y. This is x and this is y. Representing these values in a xy plane, that is x, y, y dash, x dash. This is called xy plane. Representing these values in the xy plane, say this is 1, this is 0, this is 1. Here your P of say 1 comma 1. This is called representing the complex number in the xy plane. Representing the complex number in the xy plane. Let us take another example. Z is equals to 2 plus 3y. 3i. 2 plus 3i. Here x is equals to 2 and y is equals to 3. Here x is equals to 2 and y is equals to, this is a point, y is equals to 3. Maybe another point, 2 comma 3. take another example, negative value minus minus 1 plus minus I y. Z is equals to minus 1 minus I y. Here minus x minus comma minus 1. X is equals to minus 1, y is equals to minus. If you represent here, it is minus 1, it is minus 1. Representing the these values in xy plane, writing the complex number as an ordered pair and representing that ordered pair in a complex number. Representing these complex in an ordered pair. So now let us take polar form of a complex number. Dear students, now we will discuss polar form. Polar form of a complex number can be understood by drawing xy plane. Here, P is any point in the plane. Here, this is x coordinate, this is y coordinate, and this is the angle created by on moving the line from this distance to this distance, and this OP is R. OP is OP. OP distance is R. That is written here. P be any point. Z is equal to x plus I y is a complex number. That is written as an ordered pair. That is P of x y. That is shown in the figure. That is shown in the figure. And OP is equals to R. Angle XOP is this theta. Angle XOP is equals to theta. Now, by using Pythagoras theorem, this OP is square of sum of squares of these two sides. This is X. This distance is X. And this distance is Y. R square is equals to sum of squares of these two sides, that is x square plus y square. X square plus y square. And let us take x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. From this, cos theta is equal to x by r and sin theta is equal to y by r. Now, squaring these relations, this is relation number 1. Relation number 2. This squaring and adding these equation number 1 and 2, we get x square plus y square is equal to r square plus cos square theta plus r square sin square theta. Taking r square common, in bracket we get x cos square plus sin square theta. This value is equals to 1, r square into 1, r square into 1, that is equals to x square plus y square is equals to r square. Solving for r, we get r is equals to x square plus y square. This is called modulus of a complex number. And after getting r and theta, writing them in x plus i y form, that is called polar form. That is, z is equals to x plus i y, z is equals to here x is r cos theta, x is r cos theta plus y is r sin theta. Taking r common, z is equals to r into cos theta plus I sin theta. This is called polar form of the complex number. This is called polar form of the complex number. Pause karo.